Let's learn how to pass props in a universal React web application. If you want to follow along, I recommend watching the prerequisite video first. Currently, we have server-side rendering and client-side mounting set up with React. However, all our data right now is hard-coded in the component, so our app is nothing more than a static page. Let's leverage React's rendering of the view layer by using props. Let's switch to our terminal and stop our running server. Then we'll open server.js with our text editor. Let's create a prop named title and then give it a value. We can name a prop pretty much anything, but make sure they don't conflict with prop names like style, class name, onclick, etc. Also, don't forget about JavaScript reserve words. They're off limits as well. We'll pass in our props in the second argument of react.createElement. Now save the file and open component.jsx. Here we'll update the title to this.props.title. We'll tidy up our code by removing the div. And we'll update the heading with our title prop as well. Save and quit the file. Back at our terminal, let's install gnomon globally. It monitors the files for changes and restarts the server for you. With it installed, you can now run gnomonserver.js. Excellent. In a new tab or window that's in the same working directory, run webpack with the watch flag. Now webpack will regenerate the bundle on every file change as well. You'll also notice that this triggered a restart of the server by nodemon. But technically, any changes in the public directory could be ignored since they don't affect the server logic. Let's switch to the browser and refresh the page. You can see that the title has changed, but when we click on the button, our alert doesn't seem to work anymore. What happened to it? Well, let's check the console. And it looks like we have a ton of invariant violation errors. What does this mean? Well, an invariant violation is caused by a mismatch between the server-side and client-side rendered component. In our case, this happened because when we mounted our component in the DOM, we never passed in the props. As a result, React DOM server rendered with the props, whereas React DOM did not. So let's fix that. Let's switch back and reopen component.jsx. Here, we'll need a way for our client-side script to access our props. A simple solution is to store our props in the window object. One important thing to note is that the props must be declared before bundle.js is loaded. So let's create our script tag above it. Now, JSX is an HTML, so to render our props as a string, we need to use dangerously set inner HTML and set the value in underscore underscore HTML. We'll be creating window.props, which is a global namespace for our props. Since this part will be rendered on the server side, we'll need to convert the object to a string. Save the file and open client.js. Now we need to pass window.props to the second argument of react.createElement. Save the file and switch back to our browser. When we refresh the page again, we can see that we have no errors. If you inspect the elements panel, you can see that our props are now rendered by the server. When we click the button, the alert is back at it again. So let me leave you with some food for thought. For those who dislike polluting the global scope, you could also store the props inside a data attribute. But just so you know, there's a hard limit to the amount of data that can be stored inside the attribute. And that's all it takes to pass props in a universal React app.